Good morning, everybody. This is Tom at Talon Guitar Works, and this is Kitchen Table Chronicles, where I'm going to cover a topic that's going to be near and dear to my heart. I'm a member of several guitar wiring sites or groups on YouTube or Meta, whatever you want to call it. And if not daily, several times a week, somebody comes in and says, I bought a replacement pickup for my guitar and I wired it in and nothing's working. What did I do wrong? Well, a lot of times it's not what you did wrong, it's what you didn't know before you started the project. And we're going to cover that today. The first thing I'm going to show you is several pages of manufacturers' wiring codes. Now, if you notice, they all don't use the same color code. This isn't like Underwriters Laboratory with house wiring where everything's got to be the same. There is nothing binding these pickup manufacturers to do that. Now, I downloaded those from the internet. I also downloaded this page from the internet and several others. That if you're used to wiring, this one, if I can get it up there, this one might make a little bit more sense to you. If you're a beginner, the other ones may make more sense to you. Whichever one you like, hey, go with it. But basically what it's describing is these five wire tails that come on humbucking pickups, and sometimes the 3 to 4 wire tails that come on single coil pickups, and we'll get into those later. So I have a pickup here of unknown origin. I don't know who made this pickup. I know it's a rail system pickup. And I'm going to assume that the red and white are the twisted pair. Now, what is the twisted pair? The twisted pair is the finish of both coils. And somebody's going to say, why is it the finish? Shouldn't it be start and finish? Now, remember, humbuckers are wired to oppose each other to cancel the hum. So the starts are on the outside of the coils and the finishes are on the inside. So the two inside wires on those diagrams are the finishes. So what I'm going to do to tell if I've got the right twisted pair and the right leads is I'm going to bring my handy dandy mason jar mounted multimeter in. Now, before somebody types and goes, multimeters are expensive. Here in the United States, Harbor Freight used to give away multimeters twice a year. You don't have to have the best multimeter in the market, a Fluke or something, to be able to measure pickups. All it needs is this little symbol right here that looks like a set of headphones, and that's the ohm symbol, and be able to set to 200K ohms. So, I've got my handy-dandy mason jar mounted multimeter here, and I'm going to take my tails here, and I've decided that green and black are going to be the positive and the negative, and that red and white is a twisted pair. So I'm going to touch green and black to my leads, and I get 14.3. Now I'm going to let go of one lead, and I'm going to grab the twisted pair. This number should be half, and it's 7.4. So now I'm going to let go of the other lead that I have, the main lead, and I'm going to go to the opposite one with the twisted pair, and I see 6.8. This pickup is not exactly symmetrical, but if I take jumper cables now and I were to wire this into my system and it was not making a lot of noise or sounding thin and brittle without strings mounted above it, you could do that. The pickup is in phase and you're cleared to go ahead and solder that in. If it does make a lot of noise, then you may need to switch the leads. Now somebody out there is going to type and say, well, green is never going to be the ground lead, right? Or the hot lead. Shadow pickups. Yes, green is the hot lead. So, this isn't a shadow, but it could be. I don't know. But if you have noise, reverse the two leads. If it still continues to have noise, I may have assumed wrong on the twisted pair. If you take those, the red and white that I twisted together initially apart, and you twist the green and black together and then test it again, you are going to get the same readings. And if you wire it in this time and there is no noise, then you have the pickup correct and it is in phase instead of out of phase. And there you go, 14.3, doing it the other side. Now, symmetrical and unsymmetrical pickups, where one coil is wound more than the other coil. We're going to go over the topic of coil split and coil tap. And I know there are people that are going to start throwing darts immediately. I could hear you typing. Coil split and coil tap are not the same thing. Why aren't they the same thing? Well, Gibson faked this out. Gibson likes to do coil taps, and that's where they have unsymmetrical humbucking pickups that are wound. And they use the lower ohm of resistance coil on the coil tap to produce a certain tone versus equal coils to produce a certain tone. Now, this gets even more dramatic when it's put on a single coil pickup, and it was popular for a while for country guys with Telecasters to go ahead and coil tap their pickups, single coils. And I'm talking about the three wire leads that come off of them, but not the three wire leads where one is the ground for the neck chrome pickup cover and one is the ground for the base plate for the bridge pickup. There's a separate leg that comes out of the pickup and you'll know if you got one. And those were just to give them a little bit different variants. Now they've got super switches that could do all that stuff where they don't have to do it like that. They could slug down the pickup if they want with resistors and everything else. So hopefully this will take the guesswork out of wiring in your replacement pickup into your existing guitar. And the last thing I'm going to talk about are these pickup covers. A lot of people say, well, I want to take my pickup covers off. And you could take those covers off and by desoldering here and here. The problem with that is you guys get the solder guns hot enough to where it melts the wax potting that's on the pickup. If it does that, it can expose portions of the bobbin. So when you take the pickup cover off, you could break a bobbin wire, which means you need to rewire that pickup. The other thing that can happen is enough wax melts away from it where the pickups become microphonic. Now you've got to repot the pickup before you put it in and clean the wax off the bobbins that you thought were going to look really cool in the first place. If you're just doing it for looks, don't do it for sound. So this is Tom from Talon Guitar Works. I hope this video helped you out. If you have any questions, type them in the comments below. I answer almost all the comments. And remember, only half my ideas are any good. You got to decide which half.